I'd like to call the North Kooch Ching Area Sanitation District meeting to order December 20th, 2016, 8 a.m. Roll call. Let the record show that all members are present. Is there any input from the audience at this time? There being none, additions and deletions to the minutes of December 20th, 2016. Are there any?
We have to add formal appointments of negotiation team.
Under old business? Do you want that? Or?
Sure. We've never formally done them in a meeting. And we should talk about retiree insurance just one last time to clean that one up. And budget.
I don't have enough room.
Oh,
okay. Appointment of negotiating committee and retiree.
Yeah.
And the last one was again.
No, we're good on the last one. I thought it was budget, but it's on there.
Any others?
I'd like to open up the October 18th minutes again. Correction, addition.
That's on the old edition.
October 18th?
Yeah.
Okay.
Approved, yes, that's under old business, item one. Any others? There being none, the chair would like a motion to approve the agenda.
So moved.
Mr. Bergman, so moved.
Second.
Mr. Blair, second. Discussion? There being none, call for the question. Mr. Farmer?
Yes.
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 I vote yes.
I vote yes. Okay. Minutes, November 15, 2016, NKASD board minute, board meeting minutes. Any additions or corrections on those?
Correction. Correction. When we talked about the payment or for Pemberton Law to come up, that was. You've got it kind of confusing here because that was done by a board vote on the social media.
Where are we here in the minutes?
About to the bottom. Right at the top of the bill being paid.
First page?
Yeah. First page, yeah. Second paragraph up from the bottom, okay. Basically. Bottom of the paragraph, we're talking about that.
What's your concern again?
And what I'm saying is that vote was done on social media, which is illegal. That was brought up. That was done on the internet. To spend the $2,500 to bring the attorney up for that one time, that one day.
Oh,
and it was voted on the internet.
But that wasn't this part of it. This is just to hire the law firm.
That's really got, that was an expense that you were asked for approval from the board members.
That was after this. This
no.
is talking about when we actually hired her. And
I'm not talking about when we hired her. I'm talking about when you had her come up to spend that $2,500 or $2,900, whatever it was.
Right, but that's not what this paragraph is talking about. This is when we actually increased.
That's
where
I brought it up. No, that is where I brought it up at, though.
Did we not pay the $2,900 for that? Did the law
you asked for $2,500 is what you actually asked for, and permission to have her come up for that one day for the board.
Oh, the very first meeting that you walked on? No, you
yes.
went to, you walked out on?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, did...
That vote was done in violation of the open meeting law.
Okay. So my question is this, was that bill presented to us at a later date after that?
I've never seen it.
I haven't seen it. I think we just had her, we voted to approve her, to put her on a retainage.
Yeah.
So, you know, I don't know if she's invoiced
no.
us for anything.
The retainage was done a month before.
Mm-hmm.
This was specifically to bring her up here for that
first meeting.
For that first meeting with the board, that she was going to be present, physically present here.
Mm-hmm. Well, it wasn't really a vote, but a consensus to bring her up. But I understand your point, and my reasoning behind it was that the board approved hiring her.
I understand that. But you did take a vote on the internet over the email. It was a vote taken to expend that $2,900 and have her come up here for that one day.
Have we had any bills from the law firm yet?
Last month we had Pemberton Law Services rendered $6,122.
So that was part of that?
That was part of that. $2,900 or something is what it actually cost, is my understanding. It wasn't 25, it was 29 or something like that, is what you said.
Okay.
All I'm saying is you voted to have her come up here. That wasn't a part of the agreement. You voted to have her come up here for that one day, and you voted to do it.
Okay. So noted.
So I'd just like to have that added in there that it was a board vote was made. As far as I'm concerned, over the social media.
Okay.
And then on middle of the page, second page, on the motion to accept the audit, off the middle of the page with a motion by Blair, second by Rob. We voted, as far as I'm concerned, we voted to accept the audit, not the deficiencies. There was a big discussion on the deficiency.
Mm-hmm.
And we voted to accept the audit, but not the deficiencies.
I think my problem was that I've been here for how many years, they've done this audit, and we pay them like $6,000 or $9,000 to do it, and they itemize all these deficiencies, but they never get corrected. It's like we're paying them just to monitor, and nothing ever gets done about it.
But I think that's up to the board to correct them deficiencies, though.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah. And we haven't done that. And we haven't followed through with it. Yes, there's always been there, but we haven't followed through on it. So I'm just saying, we voted to accept the audit, not the deficiencies.
Well,
is how it was broke out, if I remember it.
Mm-hmm. So we'll strike that.
So it's right here?
To accept the deficiencies in the audit as written, we're going to strike that line. Mr. Larson?
Yeah, just cross the deficiencies if you want.
So, we're saying there's no deficiencies?
Well, no, can't do that either, right?
We're just not accepting the deficiencies.
You accept the audit with the deficiencies.
To accept the audit but not the deficiencies or something like that.
Yeah. We accept the audit with the deficiencies as noted. You're not accepting the deficiencies, you're just accepting the audit.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So noted. Any others?
That's all I've got, Tim.
Was there a motion?
No, there wasn't one.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I'll make a motion.
Mr. Larson makes a motion to accept November 15, 2016 minutes. Is there a second on that?
With the corrections.
We'll go with the corrections after. Okay. We'll do it all with one motion.
I'll second.
Okay. Mr. Blair seconds. Any other discussion? There being none, Mr. Farr, call for the question. Mr. Farmer?
Yes.
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 Mr. Thompson?
Yes. I vote yes.
I vote yes.
We're still on old business,
right? We're not even there yet.
I don't know.
So, Mr. Chairman, motion by Larson, second by Blair, to accept the November 15th, 2016, with corrections. No. Does that work?
That's correct.
Okay.
Okay, minutes December 12th. We'll deal with those first.
So move to approve the minutes of the special meeting December 12th.
Mr. Billick, so move to approve December 12th, 2016 minutes. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Mr. Mr. Blair, second. Discussion. Mr. Larson?
On the last motion, second paragraph up from the bottom. We got a motion by Bill Egg, second by Blair, to cover employees deductible up to $3,100. We don't have that. Mr. Brogan and myself abstained from that vote.
Yes. Yeah, that was my mistake.
Oh, that's correct, yeah.
It should say voting yes, Armour, Bill Egg, Blair, Rob, and Rudd on that one. And then abstaining, Brogan and Larson.
Any others? There being no others, call for the question. Mr. Farmer?
Yes.
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 Yes. I vote yes.
I vote yes. December 12th, December 15th, special meeting, motion to approve.
So move to approve the minutes of the special meeting of December 15th.
Is there a second?
Second.
Mr. Blair, second. Discussion. Mr. Larson.
No, I have nothing.
So now. On the HRA and retirees, understand.
Hold it. What are you on here?
I'm right here.
Let's take this right here.
December 15th meeting.
You're in November. We've already went through that.
How the hell did I get that one? Where did that come from?
I did have a question. I mean, this December 15th, we did have a motion to negate the December 12th meeting.
No, we were going to wait until we had full confirmation that he was enrolled in the city's plan with no issues. And then I was hoping to have that by today's meeting, and then we were basically undoing that plan to be issued.
Okay.
So it's still keeping them both in factor, I believe.
Yeah.
Okay.
Just to make sure you have insurance. Okay.
Any others? There being none, call for the question. Mr. Farmer?
Yes.
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 Yes. I vote yes.
I vote yes. Please, sir, something else on the agenda. Stacy, can you give me a new agenda, please? I seem to misplace it here. Okay, disbursements, December disbursements of $63,062.82. Motion to approve.
So moved to approve.
Mr. Billick, so moved to approve. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Mr. Thompson, second. Discussion. Mr.
Greg, what's Marco Technologies?
That's our copier now.
Okay, copy.
Mr. Larson?
I see you've got a meeting agenda, but you got the $5,500 for the operators. Can we discuss that now, then? For sure.
Up to you guys.
Can I repeat that?
you're showing $5,500 for operator's insurance, and it's in a later discussion, but I'd like to discuss it now as long as it's in the discussion.
Well, there's also a blanket operation to Blue Cross for $8,000, so...
Yeah, there's two of them in there, that's what I say, but you pay ahead on the Blue Cross, right?
The Blue Cross is...
So, I mean, I just want to discuss it now.
And both of them.
Blue Cross is for December, and the payment to the 49ers is for their insurance in January.
Oh, Blue Cross is December?
I thought we paid ahead, a month ahead.
We usually get the bill ahead, but it's paid for the upcoming... the day after our meeting.
Okay, this is for November, basically, that's for November, yeah. All right. Do you have any more, or do you want to wait until you go to explain that, that you're going to talk about other new business? Do you want to wait until that night?
Explain what?
49ers health. Well, it's under new business too, so.
Yeah, we can talk about it then.
Yeah.
All right.
Mr. Rudd?
So, you're saying we're going to be paying for the employees to carry their health insurance through the 49ers. What if we're not settled by January?
They can still apply to the 49ers and under their insurance.
They'll cover them whether we're settled or not? Okay.
That's the last that I heard from them, yes. And so we've submitted all the paperwork.
I got Blair. The 2010 truck at Worley Motors was $583. What was that?
Okay. That was the four-wheel drive in the front end. There's vacuum actuators to engage the four-wheel drive, and they had to be replaced.
Doesn't have manual lockouts?
No, it's automatic. It's got the automatic hubs in it. There's vacuum actuators on it, I guess. I don't understand it all totally.
Yeah, but
they said they were stuck. They had to be replaced here. So we had no four-wheel drive that stuck.
That happened to my old truck, and they just put manuals on, and it was only like $150 or $200 to put the manuals on the hub.
Because it mixes out.
Wow, yeah.
I'm
going to
use it. I mean, with us, you need the four-wheel drive.
Oh, yeah. But
the price is,
I don't know what those automatic ones.
Would you look into putting lockouts on it?
Maybe. Yeah, maybe.
We could do that.
I don't know why they go off.
I didn't realize that. You can change them out.
Any others?
On the claims?
Disbursements, yes.
Hmm?
Disbursements.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Is there, did we ever check in to see if we could go with one broadband provider, we've got Frontier and Midco. Do you think there would be any savings at all?
It's actually when Marco was here setting up the copier, we talked to them about this, and there would be massive savings if we can go to one. And it would be a little bit of an investment at first, but we'd probably run the Midco to the plant, and then they can do like a repeater system type of thing that would give us Wi-Fi back here. And then once we did that, then we can change the phone systems over and have modern professional phone systems, and the savings would be huge.
Would that include the static, really the static ISP number? I mean, normally we can figure that out.
Yeah, and they also said, or somebody mentioned that Paul Bunyan's coming to town too. He's not logging up here, but he's the telephone system with all the high-speed internet and stuff. So yes, when I can get to that,
okay, we can.
There's big savings.
All right.
There's one more thing that I would like to add on here that kind of came in, well, I kind of missed and came in a little bit late at the same time. I'd like to reimburse our retiree, Mr. Rapaway, for $69.23. 60 of it is for the refiling of his 2014 taxes because of the HRA, and $9.29 in interest. So I'd like to be able to cut a check to him for that.
Okay, let's take that up under right after this under a new motion, okay? Any others?
That one to the operating engineers for $5,500, has that been paid?
No.
Okay.
It's in with today's disbursements.
And that $8,000?
$8,000 was for December 1 to December 30th. Okay. And this is for January 1 to February 1.
Okay.
Any others? There being none, we'll call for the questions.
Yes.
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 Yes. I vote yes.
I vote yes. Now, we need a motion to...
I would so move to refund Bob Rappaway $69.23.
Moved by...
29 cents.
29 cents?
Yep, sorry. I don't want to miss that 7 cents.
So moved by Mr. Billig. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Mr. Larson, second. Discussion. There being none, call for the question. Mr. Farmer?
Yes.
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 Yes. Oh boy, yes.
Yes. Okay, financial under disbursements, we have financial report. Motion to approve financial report.
So moved.
Mr. Billig, so moved to approve financial report. Is there a second?
I'll second.
Mr. Thompson, second. Discussion. So, Cindy, can you give us a short synopsis how we did for the year? Are we ahead of, are we under budget, over budget, in your opinion? Discussion under financial reports.
I just know it's a lot of negatives in front of the red numbers, and I don't know what that means. But that the amount that's we're under budget from last year or over budget?
If it's an income and it's red, that means we budgeted more than we gained. And if it's an expense, then we budgeted more than we had for expenses. On the income side, red is bad. On the expense side, red is good.
So dollars, dollars over budget, red and negative is not good.
That's under budget then.
Oh, that's
and
under?
It just means that it's under budget. So in income, red is bad. Expenses, red is good.
So what we're showing then is we're $62,000 less than what we budgeted and what we've taken out.
For revenues.
For expenses. Revenues, yeah. $62,000 less on expenses.
Than what was budgeted.
Than what was budgeted, yes.
Yeah.
See, and when you look at this one, to tell you the truth, we won't know the answer to where we finished 2016 until all of December goes in anyways. But when you look at this, even the second page of this financial report, this is where it gets deceiving for how we claim the PFA and the WIP, because our net income isn't really that $402,000.
Right. Because it doesn't show disbursements for the payments, right?
For the WIP.
We were going to look at that, restating those financial statements at some point in time, see if we could get it a little simpler or whatever, right?
Yep. And that's at the first year, is what my understanding was.
Yeah, we're going to actually be making those deposits. Like, we'll create an account to put the WIF deposit and then the portion of the PFA for that month into a PFA account. Okay. As soon as I can get to it.
Any other questions? Concerns? Financial report? There being none, call for the question. Mr. Farmer?
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
I vote yes.
I vote yes. Old business, approved corrections to the October, I believe, 18th, 2016 board minutes.
So moved to approve.
Billy, so moved to approve the corrections for the October 18th board minutes. Is there a second?
Second.
Mr. Bruggeman, second. Discussion?
I had another. Oh, I don't know when you want to do this. But there's an addition to those minutes that I have. I mean, we're approving the strikeout one, but...
Did you bring that up at the last board meeting?
After the last board meeting, I emailed you and you said, yeah, bring them up.
Okay.
But
let's deal with the correction. Is the correction okay? I still noted?
Yeah.
Okay. Go ahead.
In here, we approved the motion to...
What page?
The last page at the bottom, new business, motion by Billy, second by Bregman, to grant director a $1,500 increase to her current wage. Now, this motion should reflect that was per her hiring policy. She had to go through a probation that we stipulated, and that at the end of the probation, she was going to get a $1,500 raise. We just didn't willy-nilly give her a $1,500 bump.
That's correct. So we'll note that was part of her contract after her probation period, that she received a $1,500 increase. Does that suffice, Mr. Blair?
Yes.
Any others? Okay, so, call for the question. Excuse me, Mr. Farmer.
Yes.
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 Yes. Yes. I vote yes.
I vote yes. Okay. Still under old business. Union negotiations.
We completed our third round of negotiations on 14th. We're starting to get down to some of the nitty-gritties right now. We've identified the areas where the two sides kind of aren't fully in agreement, and we're just working through those to make sure that we can come to an agreement on those. We're planning on having a strategy close meeting on the 17th of January with the board to see where on these areas the board would like to go next. And then the next session is the 30th of January.
Any questions for the director? There being none, we'll move down. Approve the 2017 budget. We talked about that already. Sorry. Go ahead.
There's a couple of changes that aren't on this sheet. And this is all somewhat tentative based on negotiations, wherever we end up with that, as well as in light of the MPCA's letter that we'll get to soon, we may need to do some changes to that as well. So I'm not sure how you want to proceed, if you want to accept this with a couple changes in here and then go from there with a modified as we go next year, or once we come up with an agreement with the union. I'm not sure. So.
Mr. Larson.
I'll suggest we bring it up at the next meeting.
I think we have to
approve the 2017 budget at this meeting.
Per the bylaws.
So move to approve.
Is there a second?
I'll second.
Okay, second. Now we can discuss. Okay. Yeah, we have to. We've been postponing it for the last 3 months or something, waiting for... We could get some final numbers and we can't, but we have to make this up or down decision on the budget today.
So then do we want to add with changes? No, the budget can be changed at any time.
Yeah, we can go ahead and amend the budget.
We can amend this budget at our next meeting or whatever meeting.
Is there numbers that are going to be added to it or taken away from it?
Changed.
Yeah.
Probably a little from column A, a little from column B. I mean, I think, you know, as we're going through negotiations, by definition, negotiations are a give and take, right? So there could be changes to those numbers as they're on here. And like I said, with what the MPCA is requesting there, there could be some additions that we have there as well. So I think we have some big things that are a little bit fluid right now that I don't know what the right answer is, unless it's tentatively accepting this and then bringing it up early next year and revisiting it once we have a better feel for where we're at with things.
What if we turn it down and bring it up next year? What's the difference?
Turn the budget down?
Yeah. I mean, what's the difference?
Our bylaws state that we have to approve the budget by the end of the year.
Well, then why are we bringing it up?
Because we have to approve the budget, which we have not approved yet. This year we've been postponing it, waiting for numbers, and we haven't got those numbers.
That's what I say. I mean, if we turn it down and wait until next month to get the numbers in, what is it going to change is all
might
I ask.
But it might not be next month. We don't know.
Right. And we'll be in violation of our own bylaws by doing that. I mean,
no, I have no more questions. You're answering my question.
Do you anticipate this affecting our rates that we charge to our entities?
Well, that's the other tough part of this thing. Right now, we, depending on how long negotiations go and what we come to an agreement, we have a surplus right now, but it's not a huge surplus based on this budget. So, I mean, if I keep going back to the MPCA thing, but if that becomes a quite expensive endeavor for us, we're not going to make our budget.
Yeah. We will talk about that MPCA thing and who's going to share the burdens of the cost on that. So, we need to approve the budget. Is there any other questions? I mean, we've passed this budget over several times, so... I think we should approve the budget and then...
Bringing it up to review to make sure we're on pace until we can dial in some of these question marks that we have.
So we'll call for the question. Mr.
Yes.
Farmer?
Yes.
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 No.
Yes.
I vote yes.
I vote yes. Under old business insurance cap solutions...
That one is still hanging out there. I just haven't been able to get to that. There's only so many hours in a day.
And that's regarding Mr. Rapaway?
No, that's the employees. About how we thought the money was coming out and it wasn't coming out, and we have to make good on that.
Oh, okay.
So basically, we had the motion that they weren't supposed to go over the 1350 cap, right? Is what we're looking at.
That's correct. I believe that's correct. Yeah.
That's the part we're talking about.
Yeah.
So you've already got a motion, so I think you've got to start deducting from their check at some point.
Well, but it's the back pay issue, or the makeup that we have, because they technically owe us, so we have to sit down. Once we switch or settled out that HRA, that becomes a lot easier. But I mean,
HRA's got nothing to do with it.
Well, it did, because of the fact that one of the questions that was brought up was if we could take the $100 that the employees felt that they still were entitled to under the HRA and apply that, or have the district apply that to the premiums. That was one of the things we needed to discuss.
Okay, you want to discuss that now?
No, I'd rather, we've already discussed that, but we need to talk about this in the HR committee, how we're actually going to pull back this money from the employees. If we're going to decide that they have to write us a check and a due date, or if we're going to do a payroll deduction over time, I'd like to sit with the HR committee and figure out how to do that.
I don't think it has to go to the HR committee. It's already been discussed.
Do what you want then.
The $100 is, they're not entitled to the $100. That was a mistake.
We've already discussed that.
Yes. So that was wrong. So there is no $100 there anymore.
That's correct.
That is correct. So it's not a question then.
That's correct. But now we have to figure out how to reclaim that money from the employees. Do you want them to write you a check by the end of the year or what?
Yes, we want it done by the end of the year. It's went on long enough.
Well, my only argument was how we recoup those costs. And the health insurance, each employee was rated individually. And we wanted to lump that total amount that's over the $1,350 cap, lump that in one, and then divide it by the number of employees, and each pays a share of that percentage.
Mm-hmm. That's
not
correct, huh?
Not the individual amount, where each premium is taken less the $1,350 and that employee pays.
I understand that. That is what it was said, yes. Because we never did.
All right.
The pooling was never approved, or however we talked about it, right?
Well, I always argued that they should be taken as a group, so...
Yes, so that's what we allowed then. We allowed them to be taken as a group, and it come out to start with, there was a wrong number, 740 or something like that was discussed at the very first meeting of January.
Mm-hmm.
That was a wrong number. Now, you go on from there, Reedman and Rapaway were pulled from that group because they were retirees.
They fought, right.
So they were taken out of that pool. So whatever was the difference between the 1350 was what each individual, after it was divided by five or whatever it was,
mm-hmm.
that's what they owed over the 1350 cap.
Right.
And it changed when Beyondish got married, so that changed it quite a bit.
So I'm going to move this to the HR committee and let them
come up
with all the facts.
I'll object to the chair's decision. It should be discussed right now.
So noted. It will be discussed after the HR committee brings forward their recommendation.
No, I feel we should discuss it today and get it settled today. It's just like the last two meetings on the HR. I wanted it settled. I wanted it settled by December 30th. And this insurance issue, I want settled by December 30th, just like Bill does. I mean, we've been passing it on and passing it on and passing it on. And we have to settle it.
And it should be done by the first
kicking
year.
A stone down the street doesn't do any good.
It's been ongoing for a year now.
If mm-hmm. somebody owes me money, I want my money. I don't want somebody like you tell them, wait until next month, wait until next month. It's my money, and I want it back. And that's the way I feel.
Okay, so noted.
And we disbursed money back from the HR. We had no problem doing that to pay them. So at the same time, we should be getting our money back from them, too.
And that's only fair. What do you think, Robert?
Well, I think it should go to the HR committee and just...
Why the HR? Why can't we settle it today? Well, tell me why. You have a reason.
We'll vote on it.
Yeah, that's what I want.
Vote on it. Take a vote on it, and I'll finish it up this year.
Mike, what do you want?
Is each individual, like Steve said, it can't be that hard to figure out. So if each employee is going to owe the same exact amount?
No. Yeah, they will, yeah.
They will. So what's the problem with figuring that out? I mean, you look at what they owe and you divide it by the five and that's what they owe.
Right.
And I think before anything gets done with the union or anything else, this HRA and this health reimbursement thing should be all off the table completely. And I mean, we're going to be dragging this on forever if we don't take care of it.
Bergman?
Yeah. Is it that simple? I mean,
yeah.
Mike brought up a good point. It's that simple.
It's that simple. Yes, it is.
The rate has changed five times this year.
Pardon?
What the employees owe has changed, I believe it's five times this year because of life events.
So it's not that hard to figure out.
Yeah. Well, I would be in favor of just
If you go on a trip, five guys go on a trip and it costs so much money, you divide it by five and that's what each one pays. So what's the problem?
I'll do whatever you want.
Well, I mean, that's the simple way of doing it and getting it off the books.
Fine. Yeah. I'm tired of fighting.
Well, I like to see it done with, too, you know.
Okay, but we're not going to have this money due by December 31st because there's one of our employees that has been hammered financially because of the HRA account. So I say that if we have to do this, then let's extend it till January 31st so they can pay us back.
That's two pay periods then, January 31st.
This isn't a small number for some of these guys.
It wasn't a small number that we refunded some of these guys either. And it wasn't proper to give it to them to start with, so I don't see why you keep bringing in that $100 because it's not there.
It was a request that was made, so I carried
it forward. It's not there, it was illegal.
It was a request that was made, I brought it forward, no consensus had been carried on it. So as long as we're all in agreement then, that's what we're going to do, then that's fine.
Do you want a motion? I'll make a motion that we start deducting monies from employees. Whatever was over the 1350 cap, if they pooled it, whatever was over the 1350 cap, that we start deducting that from the employee's paycheck as of January 1st. Then it should be done by January 30th, right? We'll give them 2 months, or two pay periods.
Is there a second?
That's like
$300.
Yeah. I'll second it.
Mr. Rudd, second it. Approximately how?
It's going to be upwards of at least $300 per pay period for each of those employees.
And that's fine. Just
it's not your money.
It wasn't
so
taken out. It wasn't taken out when it was supposed to be done.
And it's not their fault.
Whose fault is it then? There
was a mistake. There was a miscommunication.
Whose fault is it then?
I'm not placing blame.
It is the administrative assistant, it is the director's, and it is the chairman's fault.
Well, if you're going to continue to place blame, then let's put it on the city as well, because they made a boo-boo too, but that's not what this is about.
That's what it was
okay.
about. Because you were asked many
Mr.
times
Larson.
Whether it was being taken out.
Mr.
It was
Larson,
brought up many times.
That's enough.
So put it where it belongs then.
Go on, question. Does this have anything to do with the union? Because we signed papers that we cannot do stuff with our employees.
That's done.
That was part of it for a while. Why we didn't act on it sooner. We were kind of handcuffed, but that is cleared now.
And that's...
Well, Mr. Larson, out of order.
Now, we're taking them as a group. So you're saying some employees are going to pay $300 a month?
No, across the board.
Went from $7 to up to $300?
No, what the problem is it was $7.60 for 2 months. It was $22 for 2 months. It went up to $100 for...
March, April, May, June, July, August, September, 7 months.
And then it went down a little bit again. So it's actually going to be even higher than 300. It's going to probably be closer to 500 a pay period if you're doing it over two pay periods.
Why was that?
Because of life changes for some people, marriages, divorces, etc.
It's only been one change that I know of.
Beyond it got married. That's the
Mr.
only
Larson, thing. Mr. Larson, please. One person at a time.
There was another change, too, but we don't need to talk about
Okay.
Mr. Rudd?
No. So maybe these guys want to pay it because they could use it as a tax write-off for their 2016 income tax, too. Maybe they want to get it off the board. It's health insurance is a deduction on your... what you paid for health insurance as a deduction on your income tax.
Only if it exceeds 10% of your adjusted gross.
What did she say?
If it exceeds 10% of your adjusted gross, which for most people it doesn't.
I just know that I'm paying $200 a month out of pocket for health insurance. and it was kind of hard to swallow because we used to get it for free, but as time changed, we had to start paying out of pocket, taking our fair share. But I guess I would be more comfortable to see what the numbers are and have a look at a sheet with who owes what, but just to make sure it's going to be done right.
Yeah, it's going to be close. It's going to be in the neighborhood over two pay periods of about $500 each to them. That's really unfair.
Why couldn't we take it on for next year, take so much pay period off for next year?
Spread it over.
And then, settle it today, but then take it over 12 months pay period next year, so then it ain't hitting so hard.
I don't know if that's legal to do it that way.
I don't know if it is legal or not.
I don't think it's legal to take that out of their
paychecks. What would be the difference? Because... But you're going to get your money back, but it ain't putting a burden on them so much.
Mr. Farmer?
Question. Cindy, you said one employee has a financial problem. When we're talking, my understanding, the money that I am talking about is money that they owe towards their own premium. I was under the understanding last meeting that we wrote these people, or we're going to write them checks on this HRA. Get that straightened up.
Only three of the five received checks, and one of them, because of the way the HRA was spent down, he was going to be subject to significant tax burden on this check.
So that the $300 that you're talking about today,
$500,
yeah, whatever you're talking about today, is just to pay back on a premium, mm-hmm, not HRA.
Correct. Two separate things.
How could it get that far out of hand?
Because he spent down all the comp money that was in his account, so he ended up with a large tax bill that had to come off of his paycheck to make it.
I understand that part, Cindy. I understand, okay? I'm asking you, how did the insurance that we have on them employees per month get to be $300 that they owe us now, $300 a pay period?
Because it was over the course of a year.
That's my understanding. I mean, we're asking them to pay for a year's worth of premiums out of pocket in two pay periods. So that's what it amounts to. Right. So,
yes,
you know, it's a burden for those two pay periods, but it's actually for 12 months worth of health insurance.
That should have been taken out as they went along, yes.
Yeah. What did it? It was an error.
But the city was supposed to be taken out, and they didn't.
That's not an excuse. That's an excuse, because I've already checked on it. Everybody's aware that the proper information was not sent to the city.
That's not right.
That is too right.
The letter was sent in January. It just wasn't signed.
It didn't have any numbers on it. It didn't have any names. It didn't have any numbers.
It had numbers. It didn't have names.
I don't think so.
I have a problem.
So you guys are questioned almost every month, and you kept saying it was being taken out.
That's because we didn't know until July.
You didn't have any money coming back.
Okay, Mr. Larson.
Until I checked on it.
We're gonna bring this back to the table, and we're gonna call for a question.
What is the question?
The question.
Motion by Larson, second by Red, to pay back anything over the cap of $1,350 over two pay periods in January.
In January.
Was it 2 months? Was it over 2 months?
Or are we going to change it?
Just over one, over two pay periods.
Yeah, we can extend it.
I think that maybe you could stretch that out a little bit. I mean,
the motion is to pay it over two pay periods, so that's what we're voting on.
Right, but if this is, I'm asking possibly a friendly amendment to the...
To how long?
Well...
You want to go four pay periods?
Yeah.
What's the reason about four pay periods?
Okay, you want to change your...
Five.
Then it's $100. Then it's $100 a time.
Oh, yeah. Stacy said five. Said five.
Okay, but that's still only $100. I guess that would be $200 out of each check.
It's going to be approximately $1,000
for each one. That's what I would get. I would like to see the actual figures on it at some point.
But then you could... I think you should do it over a year and then...
No, I don't think so.
No. But then you're all $100 a month.
You've done it before.
6 months?
Hold it. So, no. What? Did you make a motion or what? You just...
No, I asked about a friendly amendment.
We're asking for a friendly amendment.
Yeah.
Amendment. So we can vote on the amendment and then...
Yeah. So okay. What?
I'll make the motion that...
You amend the motion to read what?
To read five, everything the same except for five pay periods.
Okay.
Yes.
Is there a second?
Okay. I'm agreeable to six pay periods.
The motion is five.
I'd like to make a friendly moment.
No,
to make it six.
Out of order, Mr. Larson. We have
a
motion
it.
On the table.
I'll second it.
No, we can do the...
Are you withdrawing your motion? Hold it. Quiet, please. Are you withdrawing your motion?
You know, I don't know how that works. I think if we voted on his first, and then we go back up.
I'm not going to accept two amendments.
Well, okay, then I'll withdraw my.
I'll withdraw my amendment.
Okay,
to start with.
So,
we'll just start over.
Yes. Go ahead, Mr. Larson.
I'll make a motion that we
amend the motion.
Amend the motion that we will deduct from the employees the overage on the insurance and extend it out for 6 months, or not six pay periods to pay it back to the district.
You got that, Stacy?
I'll second it.
Mr. Farmer, second. Now, discussion on the amendment.
Is that legal to do that?
I don't know.
I mean, hey, you got to be careful. I mean, I don't know if you can legally do that.
Yeah.
Discussion. It should have been paid back over the course of a year. We're letting them six pay periods, so I don't know what the difference is. It does have to be paid back, mm-hmm. is what I'm saying. So just all we're talking about now is over the how length of course we're going to go. And I'm just saying six pay periods.
The only
if you
thing
want to make it longer, then that's up to you.
The only thing I'm saying, is it legal to do it that way?
Why isn't it? It was supposed to be a payroll deduction to start with. And that's all you're doing.
I mean, we could, too, it's winter time now and expenses go up a lot more for our employees and all of us. Do we let it ride till spring or something and then take it out when the living costs drop somewhat? I mean, I know they owe it, but I want to make it as easy as I can for the employees, too, right?
Why don't you just give it back to them?
It was, what meeting was it? August meeting is when I was brought up. That was still within the mediation part of it. You never started taking it out from September 7th is when they voted, I believe. What happened from taking it out from there on? It was never done after you were notified that it was wrong.
Maybe you should leave it there for the vote.
Yeah, there's no question. Nobody's got an answer.
Let's call for the question on the amendment to the motion.
Yeah. Would you read it, please?
Ms. Cam, would you please read the amendment?
The amendment is by Larson, second by Rudd, to pay back anything over the cap of $1,350 over six pay periods. Be deducted from the employees over six pay periods.
Mr. Farmer?
Yes.
No.
Yes.
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 No.
I'm going to abstain.
Why?
I know they owe it and they have to pay it back, but I just would like to see it made as easy as we can. I'll vote yes, then. Fine.
I vote no. Motion's approved. Call for the question on main motion as amended.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
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 No.
Yes.
No. Okay. MPCA compliance letter. Everybody has that in their packet. That's a bombshell. To our entities and to the workload of the current director. Any discussion on that? Any questions for our director, Mr. Larson?
All I'm going to say is this has been an ongoing issue for numerous years. And this is where we should have a committee to look at this, is what I'm going to say. To have some kind of committee look at it.
Well, actually, he mentions that he wants to have a meeting the first week of January. And he suggested that we have two or three members of the board meet here to meet with him to discuss that.
Mr. Chairman, I would really like to be part of this, but I'm not going to be here. We've done a lot of work on the I&I situation. So if we could move that in February, we can request it, if we could request it, if the first meeting be moved to February.
When are you back?
Hmm?
When are you back? What's the earliest?
January 31st. February 1st. I would kind of like to know why we were targeted for this. This is a pretty heavy hammer, pretty big hammer that they've got coming down here.
We're not the only ones that have gone through this. We were just wrapping up with one of the smaller cities on the range area. I can't remember which one you said it was. But they've gone through a very similar situation as this.
Somebody on the range as well?
Yeah, they've actually just finished executing this type of thing that they've lined out for us.
And Mr. Bregman, if you look, if a person was to look back at our file with letters going to the MPCA out of this office and the things that have been done and will be done and stuff, it's been a rubber stamp for several years. I mean, it's the same letter, change the date, sign it, off it goes.
I'll agree with that.
It's
all I'm saying is, go ahead.
I thought the MPCA accepted our response for I&I in past years. And now they're coming down and said, we got to hire a licensed engineer and we've got to abide by this licensed engineer's recommendation.
Our entities, I believe, have to do that. It's not like, whatever my opinion on this letter is, that all the expenses incurred by this are going to be passed on to our entities. If the district is, because it's their problem.
Right.
They're sending that to us.
We have a couple requirements.
Yeah.
And that is to, and it's all set forth in the sewer use ordinance. And so that would be our first response. That's what they're requesting, is that we have a sewer use ordinance that includes.
But I know East Kooch has submitted a letter to North Kooch to be filed with MPCA as to what we have done every year in the past. And now it is my belief that MPCA has accepted those letters.
They've accepted the information, but the problem is that we keep having these unauthorized releases, these bypasses, and so they've said, can't do that anymore. We have to start getting better.
Yeah.
So
if there is bypasses, it's not East Kooch's responsibility.
And that's why built into this, Mr. Billig, is the information that says, okay, show us your flows during wet and dry weather, each entity. Show us that you've done inspections on laterals and your lines and stuff, that they're carrying intact and they're good. This is them saying, basically, the way I interpret this is they're saying, North Kooch, you haven't done your diligence to make sure that these bypasses aren't happening. So now we're going to make sure that you're following something that we've had experience with in the past, like a recipe, to make sure that you can stop having these bypasses.
But some of these bypasses that they're referring to are from the 100-year flood.
But not all of them.
No, there's some recent ones this year, even, yes. But you're talking, when you're talking East Kooch, you're talking all the entities. City of International Falls, Rainier, you all got to show that what you're doing to reduce these bypasses.
Yep.
Another question, though. Have you checked with the PFA to see if what that money we've got left can be used for that?
From what I can see, it can't be. The PFA loan was approved for that, the expansion, and anything that we would use that remaining money for would need to be approved and routed through PFA and the MPCA as well.
But my question to you, Mr. Larson, why would we want to expend our funds trying to figure out what the entity should be telling us what's going on with their infrastructure?
There could be some factors. It's talking about operations, possibly changing operations at the same time. I mean, there's all different factors in there. I'm just saying, you're going to have to experiment with some of this stuff a little bit to see if we can improve that, get our flows through faster, basically, is what they're asking, or reduce the flows. So we've got all the options out there. It's just that we do have to address it now.
Yeah, absolutely. Mr. Brenneman?
Yeah, I would request that we invite our House Representative Rob Eklund to meet with us. I think this should go up the chain a little bit and have him educate him a little bit about what's going on.
Okay, I agree with that, but first of all, we have to decide what we're going to do about this letter, and if we're going to ask for a extension for a meeting till February, which we don't know if he'll grant that or not. So let's deal with that kind of point right now. Just so, would you like me to appoint a committee that will meet with him and will establish the committee, and then we will have our director contact the MPCA with a request to postpone it. And our reasons, Mr. Bregman, you know, his history of being here, we'd like him on the committee. And go from there. And if that's not going to be acceptable for the MPCA, at least we'll have our committee members to meet with them. Mr. Blair.
This notice says within 30 days, the director is supposed to submit a letter.
Within 30 days of coming to an agreement on what we're doing. Because basically, this is what they're, this part from like part five on, that's what their recommendations are for a plan for us. All of that is up for negotiation with the MPCA. Some of it they're going to feel pretty strongly about, and some of it they may agree that we can change it. So that's what that initial meeting is for, to be able to hammer out what our plan is. And then within 30 days of that, that's kind of when the clock starts ticking. Okay.
So I agree. We got to get an extension because we got way too much on our plate right now. But one thing I'd like to say is this: the plant renovations upgraded the plant to 3 million gallon capacity. Okay. Well, evidently we can't handle 3 million gallons. And on the news the other day, they said we're going to continue to have these mega storms now. It's just the way the mm-hmm. atmosphere is.
You know, I think when we have this meeting, I personally think we should have Gary Skolman here.
We can't.
Huh?
The meeting has to be between North Food personnel and the MPCA only, because they will only talk to us directly about this. We can talk with our entities, but they can't talk to any representatives of our entities.
My understanding is Gary Skolman has some ideas that can help us.
Yep.
It's going to be a cost factor, so I mean, maybe the committee, if they meet before, should have Gary here and get hit and let him point out what we can do to...
Well, that'll be part of the city's plan that they put together. They have to do the heavy lifting on this. The three entities have to do the heavy lifting. This isn't up to North Kooch. We're basically just the enforcement on this.
Mr. Larson,
I'll make a motion that we request an extension. Request an extension to meet first.
If I could suggest, I think in the document it gives some 30
days. There's a motion on the floor to request an extension. Is there a second?
I'll second.
There's a second. Now we can go.
I didn't think he had completed it. I just wanted to say it's doing 30, 60, 90, do 60. 90, 120 days.
But if we get the extension, then that allows that all for you too.
Right, well, that's
so I'm just saying, do
a specific number, that's yeah. All. Yeah.
So make an extension until after February, or after January 31st. Is that what we want, an extension until after January 31st?
We just want to set the meeting in February if we can, with the MPCA.
Okay, that's the understanding.
Well, second.
Oh, we got That's okay. We got it covered, Mr.
Well, I know what you can do. I mean, rather than shut the gates at the ponds and let everything from the city run to the plant, can't we put a reverse pump in and pump some of that from the
city
to the ponds?
That'll be discussions down the road.
That's an option,
yeah. That's a very expensive option, but that's one thing, yeah.
We have the storage capacity at the pond, so I believe.
All of our options are going to be very, very expensive if we...
Okay.
The other thing that I would recommend is that because of the fact that we need to enter into contractual agreements with our three entities, because those don't exist, that I think that we have a lawyer help us out with that as well, because we do need to enter into contracts with them. And the contracts will also include how fines that are administered to us are levied to the entities.
Isn't that already in the sewer use ordinance, so? I mean, we can just invoke that, send a copy of that, possibly. I mean,
I don't know what the sewer use ordinance is, if you can show that to me, because we've tried to find any contractual agreements that we have with the entities, and other than our service agreements that we have with these groups, I've never seen anything.
Right. We have the enforcement power in our enabling legislation.
But there's one sentence. There's not actually an agreement of any sort.
Right. Mr. Larson.
Let's just take one thing at a time here first.
Yeah.
Before we get into the attorney.
Well, that contract will have to be executed 30 days after a meeting with
the... After the meeting, yeah.
Up to the board. Okay. We'll call for the question on asking for an extension to the MPCA.
It's not an extension. I'm just setting a meeting later.
Yeah. A meeting date later in February. We want it in February sometime, or after January 31st.
January 7th or something like that, I believe it read, isn't it? They want a response.
Second.
We wanted to come the week of January 2nd.
Anyway, okay, call for the question, Mr. Farmer.
Extended to January 30th, yes.
Yes.
That wasn't the motion.
Motion was
January 30th. It was February.
No, it was January
31st.
Second by Farmer to request to meet with the MPCA after January 31st.
I'm going to be back. Mm-hmm. Okay, yes.
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 I vote yes.
Yes.
Who's going to be on that committee?
Okay. Are there volunteers for that committee? Mr. Brugman, I'd like to point three.
Yeah, I'll do it.
Is your term expired next year?
Could be. It isn't just yet.
Okay. Ms. Farmer? Mr. Larson? Okay. Decision on repairs to the 2015 Ford F-150. Who's going to talk about that one?
We got some pricing on you to fix the transmission from Worley's, as you see there, and also Carlson to repair, and Jerry come in close to $1,000 cheaper to fix that truck.
Mr. Reddick?
We have transmission trouble with two vehicles?
Just one.
I thought there was an older one that had transmission trouble.
Yeah, it's a 2005, is what it is.
Well, it says 2015 on this.
It's a 2005.
Okay. But
that transmission would be 3 years on 100 miles. It's the same transmission that Worley's quoted us. Or we could go with a used transmission. 90-day warranty on it only.
I know my personal opinion is the truck is that old. It's 11 years old almost. I mean, we have budgeted for another truck. I mean, personally, I think probably the truck should be replaced. that's, you know, I mean, the truck isn't worth a whole heck of a lot. And, I mean, we don't necessarily have to buy a brand new truck. I mean, we could find a decent used truck or something. Does the color make a difference to you? I mean, maybe we should look at it that way, just replacing this truck. It's got 98,000 miles on it. And I mean, when you think about the 98,000 miles, the hours it sat and idled and everything else, I mean, maybe we're better off to replace the truck. That's what I would do, but.
Mr. Larson?
Has anybody done an evaluation of that truck to see what it's worth as of now?
What it's worth right now?
Yeah.
Book price? I'm not sure what that is.
But I would guess it's probably only worth what the transmission's worth.
Probably.
I would guess, just look. I would suggest that we've got it budgeted for and that we get bids from three car sales, well, whatever you want to say it, and get three bids anyways, and look at buying and purchasing a new truck. I'll make that a motion.
I'll accept that. Second?
I'll second.
Discussion?
Where would the three be? We have two local.
We want three bids. That's.
Are we talking brand new trucks or?
Brand new trucks. I forget about used trucks.
Okay.
Who was the second?
Dave. Mr. Farland.
Do we qualify to bid, buy our vehicles on the state bid?
Yeah. See, we're going to give us a price already on that.
On a brand new truck? I think that's the best way to go, is just replace the darn truck.
Any further discussion? Call for the question, Ms. Farmer?
Yes.
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 I vote yes.
Yes. Buy a new truck. Clarification of Bowman quote and payment.
Last month we thought the payment was too high as opposed to the quote. They were identical, and I was just letting you see Mark Allen's email with the quote. That the payment, that the invoice received by Bowman's was correct.
Any questions about that? There being none, thank you, Ms. Cann. Appointment of negotiating committee. Chair appoints. Why?
You never formally did it, so we just had to circle back on that.
Okay, well, circling back on appointment to Mr. Bruggeman and Mr. Blair.
But,
okay. Negotiating committee. This is just to clear up some
paperwork.
This is for going forward with negotiations?
Well, originally. You're not going to be here.
I'm not going to be here.
Yeah.
So.
We'll let the next chairman handle that. Unless somebody else wants to volunteer for replacing Mr. Bruggeman on our next negotiating committee.
What are we discussing right now?
The negotiating committee, I'm not going to be here for the next month.
Yeah.
So.
Okay, I'll volunteer then.
Well, you volunteered and quit.
Well, okay, then I'll quit. Let's put it that way.
What do you want? You want to be on it or you don't want to be on it?
I'll be done.
Okay.
I'll volunteer to go on it.
Okay, Mr. Rudd.
But I would like. Yeah, I mean, if any of the other board members would like to come to these negotiating meetings, I'd be more than happy to see them there, because there's a lot of things that I went to the last one, and I think there's a lot of things that we have to discuss, and I think the more the board members know about it, the better.
Yeah, I think so too.
We just have to make sure that there's not more than five there. Five.
Well, absolutely, yeah. I mean,
lots of details in these contracts.
Right. And I mean, just what I've sat in that meeting, and I think we have a lot of work left to do.
Okay. So noted. The invitation was always there for board members to show up. Okay. Retiree health care, that was an addition to old business.
Oh, yeah. We're in the process of enrolling you in the city's plan. Rather than call a special meeting, is there a way that we could have you vote that assuming, or that if everything goes well with the city's plan, that we just automatically cancel the plan 282 that we had? Unless you want to have another special meeting.
No, I think we could have a motion that if the city accepts him, then the previous, then, you know,
we can. How do we say? Basically, we've already got a motion to accept it, yes.
Yeah.
And then we can wait till she can do it, and we can wait till the following meeting to okay it as far as regular meeting. Two, because we got to take one back then.
Yeah.
Well, that's the thing. As soon as we have official notification that he's been enrolled in the city's plan, I'd like to cancel that other plan as soon as possible so we don't have to worry about any incurred.
Yeah, and we'll let you make that decision to cancel them. Just come up at the next regular meeting then.
Okay. Just wanted to make sure we're all on the same page with that.
One question.
Go ahead.
Has he been accepted into the city, or are we waiting for to see if he's going to be accepted?
Everything on the city's part, to my understanding, has been taken care of. We're just waiting for the official word from Blue Cross that he's been enrolled.
Okay.
And we did have a motion to place him into the at a special meeting. So
yes, all right.
We got that covered.
So everybody's okay with the fact that once he's enrolled in that city's plan, like we get full enrollment for him, I'm authorized to cancel plan 282?
I would so move
on
that.
I don't know, we don't have a motion. So.
We don't have a motion on that, but so move.
I we'll just made a motion to authorize.
Motion by Billick, second by whomever, to cancel Rabway's 282 plan from Blue Cross Blue Shield upon acceptance into the city.
I'll second.
Yeah, second. They'll clear it up right now.
One other question. Is there going to be money owed to the city that you're not authorized to spend yet? Is there some motion that we to cover the expense? How is that done?
That was that agreement that we decided, or that we authorized Jim to sign at the special meeting. And that talks about that payment.
It does?
The district hereby agrees to make payment to the city for the full amount of health care costs incurred to provide either single or family coverage to the retired employee, with said costs to be paid to the city on a monthly basis.
Okay. I got something else, so we're looking at a vote for Mr. Billings then, right?
Yes.
Okay. We'll do that first.
Just one note. We employees at one time had been a part of the city pool for many years, and then somehow it got changed, and so now, you know, so it's got a precedent to it. That
okay, we'll call for question.
Yes.
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 Yes. Yes.
I vote yes.
I vote yes.
As long as we're on the subject of the insurance, I'd like to entertain a motion that we put 49's insurance on a blanket payment.
I'll accept that motion.
I'll second it.
Discussion? Quietness, Phil.
Second by
Mr. Farmer.
Yes.
Call for the question. Mr. Farmer, I'm sorry.
Yes.
Go ahead.
Yes.
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 I vote yes.
Yes. Thank you. Okay. That third one, we dropped that, right? I believe you had three you wanted to add and you dropped one.
Yep.
Okay. Okay, staff and committee reports. Operator report. Mr. Schneider.
Mr. Chairman and board members, just a few things here this past month. It's been kind of a busy month for us. The flow meter that we ordered, we did receive the flow meter for lift station 7. We have not put it in yet, and we will be getting to that as soon as we can. We'll get that flow meter installed out at lift station 7, the new one. But we did receive it. Also, biosolids Our biosolids annual report is due December 31st. That has been completed and delivered to the MPCA. And we're just waiting for a confirmation letter from them saying that they accepted it. Also, something also a little bit new for us this year with the biosolids annual report is that each year that report has to be reported to the EPA. We've never dealt with that before. Now, Georgia from the MPCA, who dealt with all the biosolids requirements, she took care of that. Now they're wanting the entities to take care of reporting the biosolids and report to the EPA. So we're working with Mountain right now, Environmental, who does our biosolids hauling and stuff, and there's going to be some seminars, online seminars, that they're going to attend to find out exactly what it's going to take to report these reports, this annual report to the EPA. So we are in, you know, we're in communication with them about getting that taken care of too. Also, boilers, our boilers have been in the plant, been running real well. We usually have general heating come up once a year and go through them, and we've been in contact with them. And we're trying to coordinate it with when they come up to do other boilers around town. He's going to come in and just do a tune-up on our boilers, check the exhaust gas temperatures and stuff, and whatever he does that he checks and puts his meters and stuff on there. So we're trying to coordinate that with him when he comes into town to just come in and just tune up our boiler and check them for us. But they have been running real well for us on the methane and the natural gas. We haven't had any trouble at all with our boiler system. We had some issues out in East Kooch. We had to replace a few pumps on a few lift stations. A couple pumps burned out. Took a little time to install some new pumps. Two horsepower pump we had to put in a lift station. Also, we had this lift station 4 up the lake. We had to put a brand new 3-horse in, and we had some issues there. Got all the piping ready to go. We lowered the pump down the hole, and the piping broke off the wall on us. Filled the station up. And we were letting it down in the hole and trying to get this flange to hook up, and the valve and everything busted right off on us. So it was kind of an emergency. It was late in the day. And what we did is we called Crandall right away, got him out there. We pumped the station out, and then we set up for a confined space entry, went down in there. We had to take some piping apart and get a cap on one of the pipes, so we could at least get through the night and run the station overnight. The next day we did the same thing again. We pumped it down, sucked it out, and did our confined space entry and went down and replaced some of the piping in there. Now next summer that whole station is going to have all new stainless piping in it. Some of that was original piping from years ago yet, but it was kind of an emergency there. We were in a hurry. It was getting dark, and we were able to get that back online for the night.
Is that East Kooch?
Yeah, it is a structure.
Okay.
And whereabouts is that lift station located?
That's just past by the roadhouse there. When you turn off the roadhouse and go straight east down that road there, put the old car down that way, right down there. So that was kind of an emergency for us. Also, ferric. We just received another load of ferric sulfate the other day. We are averaging about every 2 months we're getting a load. And we do watch that usage really close. We do in-house testing twice a week. Our last limit, we averaged at 0.6 milligrams per liter, where our limit is 1. So we do in-house testing, and we regulate that up and down as we see fit. If we're starting to get way down, then we'll adjust that ferric sulfate down. If the flows come up, you can notice that our limit starts to climb a little bit, so we got to tweak it up a little bit. But we are watching that twice a week, in-house testing, twice a week, and also we met our limit at 0.6, so we're well within our range. We're still getting our ferric through Hawkins. We used to get it through this DPC. Hawkins had the best price for us, and we figured we were probably saving about $550 every time they bring the load. So, and I just confirmed that with them the other day, and that our pricing is still the same with Hawkins Chemical. Also, about 3 weeks ago, John was on duty, got a call for a lift station up the lake, the pole holding our panel and stuff with the wind, it broke off at the base. The pole was leaning like this. So what he did is he went and got bracing and stuff, braced up the pole to stabilize it until the following Monday. We got a hold of Minnesota Power. They came up with their truck and straightened it out, and then they got it all braced up. We just about, let's see here, it was on the 9th of December, they were able to help us out with that and replaced it and put a brand new pole in there. This was up the lake. So we have spent a little time up the lake on different issues. Our permit is going to expire December 31st. I called John Thomas a couple days ago and just wanted to confirm him that we're coming to the deadline, and he said, don't worry about it. It's out of your hands. It's in the MPCA's hands now. So we are going to be operating under the old permit after December 31st. We did receive letters back in June. We had the permit sent in, finished and sent in March 28th. It wasn't due till July 4th. We had it done March 28th. June 8th, we receive a letter from them saying that our application is complete. All complete, ready to be submitted. So we've been sitting waiting. So our application is accepted. I mean, everything's complete in the application. We're just waiting for a permit. That's what they figured. And that was due July 4th. So that gives them 6 months to write a permit. We still don't have it. They said they're way behind. But they said our application is complete. So we're just going to be operating under our old permit. So there should be nothing to worry about. Also, the last thing here, this past month, we met all of our standards for the month. And that's kind of the things I have for this month. There is other day-to-day operations, you know, and snoring will go on. Clarifiers to check on a daily basis. We're checking trickling filters and lab work to do every day, you know, day-to-day operations. We do. That's all I have.
Any questions?
Thank you. Lift station 7, the flow meter, is that the one at Early?
No, that's by Rainier Park.
Rainier Park.
Yep. And we'll get that in as soon as we can here. That's all I have.
Okay, director's report.
I think we've pretty much talked about everything that I've been working on. Union negotiations, insurance, the HRA, MPCA compliance letter. On and on it goes. It's been a long couple weeks, but I think we got some of the big things wrapped up that we need to.
Thank you, Cindy, for a job well done. Get on a new business. Payment to Local 49ers for January insurance is $5,550. I guess we discussed that on their blanket authorization.
Mm-hmm.
Lord, happy with that? Moving on. NK/EK 2000, North Kooch, East Kooch 2017 agreement.
At this time, given the uncertainty with whatever we end up with the union negotiations and as we expand through Island View, I recommend that we continue just on with that agreement, assuming it's acceptable to East Kooch, and just modify it as changes occur. Kind of keep it a fluid document.
It's a pleasure of the board. That's contract expires at the end of this year, Mr. Billy?
End of the year.
So we'll need to move on this if we're going to just extend that contract. For the time being, let's get a motion on the floor, then we'll discuss. Is there a motion to extend the current East Kooch, North Kooch service agreement for 2017?
I'll make that motion.
Mr. Rudd,
I'll second moved.
Mr. Thompson, second. Discussion. Mr. Rudd.
Is that a one-year agreement?
2017.
There is clauses in there, too, that says that it can be amended at any time.
Mr. Larson.
That was my question, I guess. How long do we want to extend it for, or are we going to look at it in the future?
Yeah, it's good for a year, and the contract reads we and either party can ask for a renegotiation.
The last year we never signed until June, was it?
So, yeah, it can be renegotiated.
We should wait till we see what the bills are, what it's going to cost.
So, we're just extending it. We're not looking at it, is what you're saying.
Right.
Okay.
Unless you wanted to extend it month by month and just review it and discuss it kind of each month as things change.
The motion on the thing is to extend it for 2017.
I don't see any reason why you'd want to go from month to month. I mean, until you see what happens with the rest of East Kooch.
No further discussion. Call for the question.
No.
Mr. Billy?
Abstain.
Yes.
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 I vote yes.
I vote yes. New business, medical Part B supplemental increase.
There's just a little note there that shows you that Medicare for the retirees is going up from $104.90 and we reimburse them to $134.
So the new one is 134?
Yes.
What does it say about the 109?
What's that? Sorry?
It says 109. Most of them will be 109.
Yeah, that's what mine is.
That's what mine is.
109 on average.
Okay. Yeah. Mine is 100. So I would say it's 109.
Up to 134, so I'll know when, yeah, when Mr. Bruggeman or Nancy tells me how much their supplement actually increased.
Okay, so when will that take effect?
Next month.
Okay, so we might be expending funds that haven't been approved by the board because of the increase?
And also...
Is that correct? That could happen?
That could happen.
I got mine yesterday. Mine and my wife's went up different amounts, so, I mean...
How much?
I think mine went up around $9, and I think my wife went up $6. So, I mean, I think everybody's going to... I don't know exactly how it works.
You're paid the same as Robert. You wrote.
And then also,
I paid the same as Robert.
How do you know?
I know.
Blue Cross Blue Shield of Minnesota for January that went up yesterday.
I can't wait.
Yours went up $10?
No, went up $5.
Yeah, so see, it's 109, so most it might only be 100. Yeah, instead of 134.
That's what I said. Mine is 109 or something
like that. Yeah.
It's a supplement.
It was 104.
If John makes that much more money, get that much money, he should make up the difference.
You want to say exactly what it was.
We want to say 134.
I don't think it will that much.
Or for just for her.
Yep, I do it for all four. Two retirees and their spouses.
Up to 110 bucks.
I'll make a motion that we pay the added expenses for the Medicare payment.
As they go up? For
as they go up, yeah.
Okay. Motion to pay the Medicare supplements as they go up for our retirees. Seconded by Mr. Blair. Motion made by Mr. Larson.
To the point of 134.
Right. They might, whatever they're going to be, they might be different. So, anyways, call for the question, Mr. Farmer.
Yes.
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 Abstain.
Yes.
Yes.
I'll vote yes.
I vote yes. Correspondence, any?
Can we do the same thing for the Blue Cross Blue Shield supplement in there that also increased?
Yeah.
That I pay every 3 months for the retirees as well?
Mine didn't go up.
It just came yesterday and I paid it for the first ones, but it went up because I pay that every 3 months and it went up like 100.
Here's one up.
Will that bill be reoccurring at the same amount?
I've got a letter on it, yeah.
Throughout the year.
So can we just add retirees, Medicare, and that would include that then?
Well, we'll have to have a separate motion because we already passed that one. So we'll need a motion to pay the increase for Blue Cross Blue Shield Health Insurance every 3 months at a total of $726.45. Is that correct, Stacy? That will be constant?
Yes.
So move.
Mr. Billig, so moved.
Second.
Mr. Larson, second. Discussion? Being none, call the question?
Yes.
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 Abstain.
Yes.
Yes.
I vote yes.
I vote yes. Thanks for bringing that to our attention, Ms. Gann. Next meeting, Tuesday, January 17, 2017 at 8 a.m. Motion to adjourn. Where?
League of Minnesota Series.
That's just FYI that we got money back from the property and casualty dividend. And I put that in the checking account last week.
Yeah, I see how much? 12,000. I see it in there, yeah. 12,000 something.
Yeah, I see though that premiums have doubled, more than doubled in the last, from 07 to 16. We are getting more back too.
Before we're done, could I bring up the petty cash fund?
No.
Okay. Can we add it to the next meeting?
Absolutely. Okay, so next meeting, Tuesday, January 17, 2017 at 8 a.m. Motion to adjourn.
Actually, Mr. Chairman, I think it's time for me to resign.
Yes. I'm resigning too right after the meeting too. So, thank you for your service. You've done an excellent job, and the board, future board's going to sorely miss you.
Motion to adjourn. December 31st, I have some hours to burn up, so.
Okay. Call for the question, adjourn.
No, I got a question.
We got a motion on the floor to adjourn. Farmer.
Yes.
Yes.
Motion to adjourn.
Who seconded?
Jim Robb.
No.
Motion to adjourn.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
No.
Yes. We're adjourned.
So what happened?